Hi, I received the link from my friend, the necklace Steve. Sorry, Steve. He's my ex-colleague engineer and a very talented photographer. Make sure to check his art. Anyway, the webpage he sent claims that woman dies after dropping charging phone into bathtub. But as I've said in my previous videos, by design, such things should not happen. But it seems people still keep dying one after another. So would you or would you not die if you drop your charging phone in the bathtub while you're in the bathtub full of soapy water? Is it possible to get electrocuted in the bathtub? Of course, but there are specific protections in place to save you, at least where I live. In two of my previous videos, I checked a specific case where a young girl was electrocuted in the bathtub. She had bypassed the ground fault protection outlet by plugging her extension cord, which had frayed exposed live wires, outside the bathroom with no ground fault protection. Let me demonstrate. In North American bathrooms, we must have these GFCI outlets. And if the current, instead of between live and neutral, runs between live and earth, it detects it and shuts down. Now imagine you're in the bathtub. The faucet and drain are grounded, which grounds the water. I connected my big spoon to live wire through the GFCI outlet, and if I shove it in the water, the breaker opens. I put some soap in the water to make it even more conductive. See, I can even turn on an LED through the water. Ooh, the breaker opened. Now I put my leg in the water to show you that the protection actually works. You never try it at home. Any electricity will only run through my leg and is not dangerous. Now if I put the spoon in the water, jeez, scared me. If I put the spoon in the water, I felt some electric tickling in my toes, but the breaker quickly opened. Most of the current runs through the water around my leg anyway. It's much more dangerous if the current runs through your body first, then into the water. Let's try it. Well, that was super painful, not even compatible to if you just put the spoon in the water. Fortunately, GFCI opened, which means the current was above 5 milliamps and limited the period of pain. And let me tell you, that pain was the pain where your muscles contract and you can't let go and you're done. Thank you, GF. So this is important. If you need to plug any electronics in your bathroom, you must plug it into a GFCI protected outlet, and this will save you if anything happens. Also, if you drop your hairdryer in the water, it's less dangerous while it's in the water. It's more dangerous if you try to take it out, because the entire current runs through your body. So jump out of the bathtub first, unplug it, then remove it. And never take live wires with you in the bathtub. But what if you don't plug your phone charger into a GFCI and drop your phone in the bathtub? Still, nothing should happen because the output of the charger is isolated from the live wires. Here, I'm probing between the charger output and live wire, both plugged into the same outlet. And I see some AC voltage, but because the charger output and live wire are isolated, if I short them, there is no current running between them and the AC. The probe ground is connected to earth. Why do I keep forgetting? I melted my probe. Need more of these. I guess that's one of the reasons this video was sponsored by Keysight. This is actually good. Keysight is holding a contest for graduate and undergraduate students all around the world. The winner not only receives up to $50,000 in cash, their university gets up to $50,000 in Keysight tools. You can enter from the link below. Basically, students try to tackle two important global issues, and I will be one of the judges to pick the winners. Is that a good thing? Just for entering your idea in the contest, the first 240 eligible registrants get the fancy Keysight DMM. So do it! I'll also give away two of them at the end. And beside the cash and tools, your brilliant idea may change the world. Forgot to unplug the Anyway, here I am isolated from any conductor, and this is, of course, live. Now if I touch the white neutral wire or the green ground wire, nothing happens. And if I touch the live, never try this at home. It is okay because I'm isolated. Okay, nothing happens. Again, I'm measuring between the charger output versus the live wire, and this time with an isolated differential probe. And if I touch the charger contact versus the neutral wire, I feel nothing, which means the voltage across my body is low. But what if I touch between the charger contact and the live wire, and this shows 120 volt AC between them? Ooh, look at that. my body resistance is shorting the output, so it's actually floating. Let me make my body more conductive. There, my body shorts it completely. So the output of the charger is truly isolated, and it's pretty safe to drop your phone in the bathtub while charging. But if you drop your hairdryer in the bathtub, there is no isolation and you are only relying on the GFCI to save you. So always plug it into the GFCI. With those two protections in place, why people still die in the bathtub? Let's read up on the article a bit in one of those ad-infested pages. A woman has been found dead after using her phone in the bath while the charging lead was still plugged in. I saw Nastya lying in an empty bath. I assume the water drained over time. Milkman who's never missed a shift forced to retire after float stolen. What, somebody beat him up? According to reports, she died from a severe electric shock. Leggings for $24. In just over a year, 5 people have died in Russia having used their plugged-in mobile phone in the bath. Earlier this year, this girl died. In December, that girl died. Why is it all girls? Another 12-year-old girl listening to the music on her phone. Authorities in Russia have issued warnings about using your phone in the bathtub. An electronic engineer said relaxing in a bathroom with your mobile phone plugged is like playing Russian roulette. Well, it shouldn't be, unless I guess you're in Russia. Now, I'm not racist, but it seems like these reports are from countries where the government doesn't regulate the products sold in their market and instead tells people to be careful. That's not racist. If people are consistently being electrocuted in their bathtub, it means they're missing both the ground fault protection and the isolation in their phone charger. I don't know if you have seen the Krosen channel, a bunch of fine Ukrainian lads doing interesting and deadly projects in a successful YouTube channel. What I can't help but to notice is the environment they live in. Quite old homes and neighborhoods. And if most homes around there are aged like this, I won't expect their bathrooms to be updated with GFCI outlets. I also don't remember having those outlets back in Iran. And both countries use 220 volt AC, which is of course more dangerous. And for the isolation of the charger adapter, I'm afraid there are non-isolated chargers out there being sold. I mean, all it takes is for some guy to say, I'm gonna make a super cheap product and help everyone save tons of money and make money in the process too. And with no government regulations, they can sell it. I mean, have you seen the video reviews of the suicide showerhead done by YouTubers like Big Clive or Diodes Gone Wild? They actually sell it on Amazon too. Basically, the shower head consists of exposed wires of a heating element where the water passes through and gets hot. It showers your brain with electrified water. If you stand in the water or touch the faucets, you'll get a shock. The funny thing is that they also have a ground wire in the way of the water, thinking they are smart and this will de-electrify the water before it hits your head. But if you watch those YouTuber video reviews, you see that not only the water still has some good charge on it, but also in order to make this shower head work, you have to bypass your ground fault protection. Otherwise, the GFCI will pop open because the ground draws current from the live wire. So in order to use this shower head, you have to bring unprotected live wires with you into the shower. If something like this sells, I have no doubt there could be crappy knockoff phone chargers out there cooking people. So the moral of the story is that don't buy questionable knockoff electronics and always plug them into a GFCI outlet. And just don't bring your electronics into the bathroom with you. Just let your mind be free in that period. You might come up with great ideas that you can submit to Keysight's IoT Innovation Challenge from the link below. The deadline for your ideas is May 15th. There are two challenges to tackle using IoT solutions. Make urban life healthier in big cities and keep waterways clean. These two are real things humanity faces as the population grows. Remember, no idea is too simple or stupid. Sometimes the simplest stuff have the biggest impact. So follow the link below to learn more and submit your idea. 6 people or teams will be selected and will be given an all-expense-paid trip to New York Maker Fair, where they can demo their solutions. Then 3 winners will be picked by the judges, including yours truly. Winners take $25,000 or $50,000 cash that can help them realize their ideas and win equivalent amount of test equipment for their own university to help excel education and help improve human lives. So put your brains to work, we need it. Giveaway. In addition to the first 240 eligible registrants to this competition that get a handheld Keysight multimeter, I also give away 2 of them. For that, you can either become my patron at patreon.com or register from my link in the description for free. Thank you.